Hey, remember how last time we talked about how we can use repeated actions to create animation? Well, a repeated action is something that happens over and over again. In computer programming, these instructions to create a repeated action are placed inside a loop. Those instructions are repeated over and over again until a loop ends. In animation, we use loops that are repeated a certain number of times. Other loops keep running until the program stops. Today, we're going to focus on loops that run until something happens in the program and a condition becomes true. These are called conditional loops. Think about running a race. You start running, and you keep running until you cross the finish line. Or drinking a milkshake until the cup is empty. Or walking until you reach a locked door. Let's take another look at one of our examples. Running until you cross the finish line. Think about all the actions that repeat until an end condition is true. Can you identify both the action and the end condition? Remember, the action is what's happening, and the end condition is what causes it to stop. In this example, the action is running. The sprite is running in a race. He runs until he crosses the finish line. Then he stops. Crossing the finish line is what causes him to stop running. In computer science, a conditional loop is used to repeat a set of actions until something specific happens in the program and the end condition becomes true, causing the loop to end. Remember, unlike the loops you use in animation, there's no way of knowing how many times a conditional loop will run. It will keep running until the end condition becomes true. Today, you're going to use Teep and See to explore conditional loops and write some conditional loops of your own. Good luck!